We have a heart-touching story about how a father was able to reconcile with his estranged daughter, whom he has not seen in over a decade, through the power of Master Shah's Tao transformative technology. Sammuel Yisrael is an engineer in the United Kingdom and is the co-founder of Soul Haven, an eco-sustainable farm with an education and rejuvenation center that has delivered well-being events to many vulnerable and homeless individuals. He has been recognized by the Prime Minister of Great Britain for his outstanding contributions to communities' well-being.
Through my partner, Natasha, she introduced me to a lady called Illa, who we went to her workshops, and she introduced us to the Tao Technologies and the calligraphy and the art form. And I was really fascinated by the way that it worked, particularly the greatest forgiveness and greatest love. These really resonated with me a lot, as these were love and forgiveness were some of the things that I'd been focusing on for a long time to regarding my daughter. As an engineer, I was always using crystals to be able to power computers and using organic matter. So, the theory of energy being transformed from one thing to another was something I was very familiar with. So having the theory of being able to, that everything is energy, which comes from Einstein's theory, and learning that we can have energy from heaven and be able to, that a calligraphy or something has energy within it, was something that really resonated with me, made me really think, oh, this is something I can hold something, I can connect with it, and I can switch that on, so to speak. Just like I would switch on a computer, I can focus on this point, and I can connect with this. That really resonated with me as an engineer, that this was a technique, a tool that I could use to be able to bring peace and focus into my life. I was using a couple of other modalities. I was brought up being taught about communicating with heaven, the belief in healing, the possibility of healing. So that was kind of how I was brought up. But there was always kind of this kind of separation of one hand engineering and one hand kind of spiritual stuff. And there was always something to kind of like, this doesn't quite add up. There's something quite missing here. And that when I looked into Tesla and Einstein's work, who were trying to create that connection between their theory and healing. So when I read the book about quantum technology, that really made sense and really resonated with me. And this is the kind of missing piece. It gives me something to be able to use a lot easier than I had in the past. I was using kind of focusing prayers and meditation every day about forgiveness, love, in regards to the situation with my daughter. But I didn't quite feel connected until I started using the forgiveness and the greatest love calligraphies. I really found that helped me be able to focus so much, to be able to take a book and follow the calligraphy. And as I moved, I was able to get into a place of flow. And I felt that connected with myself, and I could feel that I was able to connect that gap, so to speak, and feel something was healing in myself. I hadn't seen my daughter probably since 2011. I had no contact with both my children for many, many years. And it wasn't until 3 years ago that my daughter contacted me through Facebook, and she reconnected with me. And that was, I fully believe this was partly because of all the work that I'd done over the many years. I first started working with the calligraphy probably in about 2013, and literally using it every day just as a matter of try to heal that heartache that I had, because I wasn't able to see my daughter or my son. And I went through many ways to try and contact them over the years, and none of them were successful. And then suddenly, out of the blue, she contacted me and she started talking to me. This is the greatest forgiveness book that I use every day to help heal the relationship with my daughter. I have the greatest forgiveness book and I have the greatest love book. And I focus on the calligraphy that you can see here, and I trace it. I follow it with my finger and I trace the whole calligraphy. Sorry, it's a bit hard to do when I'm talking as well. I'm looking at you. So I trace the calligraphy. And as I do that, in the book, there are words that you can say, but often I also use, I think of, forgiveness, love, connection. I say the name of the calligraphy and the words that are in the book to help connect with that. And, I speak her name to connect with her, and the same with the greatest love, to send love. I fully believe that forgiveness, it's not always that forgiveness and love are kind of two sides of the same coin to me, because it, it helps you connect with your inner peace, gain freedom and joy. That's what it says on the cover. It's that ability to be able to let go of whatever has happened, whatever is holding you back, and just let it go. I have to be honest, for quite a while, I didn't believe it was real. I started asking lots of questions to make sure, to make sure she was who she was saying she was. And then it was real. I've had video calls with my daughter. She connected with me because she was pregnant with my grandson. So my grandson is now 3 years old, and that's how long I've been in contact with my daughter. He's going to be three next year, sorry. So it's about 3 years I've been in contact with her. We have video calls, we talk regularly. It is such a change in my life to have my daughter, who I honestly didn't think I would ever see again. I'd lost hope. I'd lost that there was part of me that was dead, because I just didn't think it was possible. But I just kept going, well, whether I see her or whether I don't, this is something that I need to heal in my life. This feeling I have, this sadness, this grief. I need to do something. And this gave me that ability to do something, to be able to, and that's how I really resonate with this. This is something that we use at Soul Haven as well. To be able to take hold of something and focus on that point of you moving, and as you're moving, whatever you want to connect with, you can put it into it. It's not something that you're passive in. You're active. You're taking an active part of it. It's not something that you're just going to go, oh yes, that's there. You're using your body. You're moving with the calligraphy. You're giving that kind of entire focus for that time to nothing else. And that brings great healing of that time, to be able to focus on something that is beyond yourself, because you're looking at that going, this is the time to focus on this. Sometimes you need to give yourself something to believe in, to be able to move past where you are, because there's only certain things that you control. You can control how you feel about something and what you do about it. And it's not always, I didn't know that this outcome would happen. I didn't think it would. But the process was, I was just focusing on healing and the connection, to send that out and And then it just happened. I can't fully explain it. I just feel that, you know, there was that connection. There was something that happened between that. And my life has changed.